Scouts, welcome back to another week at the Chocolates Podcast. I'm Leigh.
I'm Skin.
And we have another bit of bonus content for you today, and it's in the form of an ambush from Skin's fiancée, Eloise.
Yep.
And the girl that I'm getting to know, Rochelle.
Yes, Eloise. You had like a H in her name there, Eloise, but...
Eloise Bar. Yeah.
But no, yeah, they requested to record a podcast episode over the Christmas break, like a bit of a ladies' night thing, which we were quite excited about. We thought it was nice that they were taking an interest in sort of podcasting, but
yeah. Somehow we kind of forgot, I guess, in that process that we had actually tricked them into coming to Melbourne with us to run a half marathon.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, things like that just slip your mind, obviously.
Yeah. So there's two people's minds who it did not slip, and they were Rochelle and Eloise.
Yeah, exactly. So we thought that this was going to be a nice podcast where they just got to chat about whatever they were interested in. Meanwhile, they sort of rocked up with the intention of getting access to the microphone, I suppose, just purely for the sake of vengeance.
Oh, yeah. There was evil in their hearts. Yeah.
So this is how it went.
We got the chocolates.
What the frick is that?
We got the chocolates.
Don't they do dad jokes?
We got the chocolates.
Wait, there's a podcast?
Yes.
Really?
Munchkins, welcome back to the We Got the Chocolates podcast. I'm Rochelle.
I'm Waze.
And this is Ladies Night.
Oh yes, it's ladies' night, and the feeling's right. Oh yes, it's ladies' night. Oh, what a night.
Oh, what a night.
That's sick. Oh, good.
That was cool. Yeah. Sorry, I'm not even meant to be here.
No.
Yeah, honestly, shut up.
That's Mickus over there. He films and chimes in when he's needed.
Hello.
And Dave the Brit, who knows jack shit, edits. And Charlie fact checks any ridiculous claims that we might make. Fun fact, we actually have some We Got the Chocolates royalty here with us tonight. Eloise was on the first ever episode of the We Got the Chocolates podcast. Weez, how does it feel to be head co-host today?
Happy to be here. About time. Thrilled. They rolled out. I was waiting for the red carpet, but didn't get one. But.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you own We Got the Chocolates now, which is weird.
Yeah.
Listen to me.
Anyway, you probably arrived by accident, but stayed for a laugh. We Got the Chocolates. That is a win. And I've got a story. So, we actually also have Leigh with us tonight. Welcome, Leigh.
Thanks.
Leigh, hello.
Great to be here.
Was that good?
It was pretty good, except people are staying for a laugh.
I laughed. Oh, I didn't even realise. Which
I'm not sure what that is. I think it's a hybrid of a life raft. Right. We give them away all the time.
Whoops.
It's ladies' night.
Yeah.
It's a new thing.
Yeah. Anyway, so we've recently moved in together. Ooh. And there's been some weird pieces of clothing that have made its way into our cupboard. Do you want to run us through some of your favourite outfits that you've ever worn?
Typically, they're budgie smugglers. Oh. I'm sure that's probably not what you're referring to. Biggest hates them.
Great people, though.
great people.
Some of my other outfits that I've worn were there was a big Superman costume that we gave to Charlie to run in. I typically don't usually wear that, though.
I don't think I've ever seen you in that.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
What are your favourite combos of clothing that you like to wear?
Shorts.
Okay.
Wow.
How specific are we going here?
We'll give you some.
Well, I would appreciate that. I'm okay.
Well, so since we've got Weez here and Weez has lovely sense of fashion, she's going to give you some tips.
Okay, great.
Well, I would say his fashion's improved since you've started dating this lovely lady that you're getting to know.
Yes.
Significantly.
Some might be disappearing in the washing machine.
But back in the day, like I've known you for nearly 10 years. Mm-hmm. And throughout that time, there's been some things that are a bit rogue. All right, number one, you shouldn't be wearing tie-dye shirts. I'm glad they've slowly weaned out, but you used to wear them all the time. Singlets, T-shirts, tie-dye was like your go-to.
We did have a bit of a stalk of your Instagram this morning.
Oh, no.
And they're in there a lot.
There's a lot of tie-dye.
They were big back when I lived in Byron Bay.
What?
Which never happened.
Next thing, look, I'm probably not the biggest fan of Crocs. Like Crocs aren't my go-to shoe, but I know there's a few people that probably listen and in the room that like them. But Crocs with the jibby thingies, the little clippy thingies. Yeah, you're not five, but you know, it's okay. I will accept it, but they could probably be something that you could have a look into.
Sound a lot like Gode, actually.
Yeah, good. Goaty's always right.
Rule one of podcasting.
Yeah, correct. Next thing, skinny jeans. Look, they're slowly fading, but I think, you know, we were talking this morning, is a lingering pair.
Yeah, there's a lingering pair that are not allowed to be worn.
Yeah, there is a pair that's banned, which is unfortunate. Unfortunately,
I'd say it's correct, but that's okay. And the last one's probably of a recent outfit choice that Rochelle actually saw you wear yesterday.
Last night, yeah.
Yeah, this is not good. The no-so shocks with no boobs. The no-so shows. Am I having
no-show stocks?
With runners.
Stocks?
Got there in the end. Yeah, not cool.
Is that no good either?
Wait, what?
No, so he came home in nice beige shorts with a pair of Nikes on, like running Nikes that you would go for a run in with no-show socks on.
Okay. Yeah, so not for like
it was like knee, ankle, shoe.
Are they okay if like you're going for a run?
Oh, don't you get blisters?
Are you wearing socks?
They are socks. They're just they're not non-existent.
Yeah, but what about the back of your heel? That would hurt pretty bad. Well,
that gets blisters, but you know, what can you do?
Wear real socks? Well, that's okay.
Nah, that's ridiculous.
Anyway, so after looking at your Instagram and going for a bit of a stalk on what you wear, we've decided that your AI photo that you and Mitch recently did a couple of weeks ago was a really good look for you. So we've actually got an outfit here for you to put on.
Oh, this can't be good.
This can be good. Oh my.
This is great.
So we've got a lovely leather shirt for you and a tag on.
That's not going missing.
You
that's
went to
staying.
The shops to buy me an outfit.
Oh, Lifeline, great people.
Oh, right, okay.
So we've got this for you to put on, lovely leather shirt with a lovely little chunky silver chain.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I don't mind it.
I've got the feeling I'm also not going to mind it.
That is concerning. That will go missing in the washing if that happens.
Yeah.
Wait, when am I wearing this?
Now. All right. The AI version of Leigh is back. How do you feel?
Hot in this thing.
Oh, boy, do you look hot.
No, yeah. I don't mean that type of hot.
Around. That's going out on Saturday night, that outfit. That's gorge.
It's a lot of chest there on display.
Well, that's what happens when you go to the gym as much as I do.
Oh, okay. Let's go. Yeah, no, it looks great. How do you feel? Do you love it?
Yeah, I'm always looking for a point of difference, somewhere to stand out in a crowd. So I think this has probably done it for today.
How close did we get to the photo?
I also haven't got to see my face, so I don't really know what I look like. And Mickus is shaking his head as in it's not great to look at.
Shaking my head up and down.
It's beautiful. Maybe it's Maybelline's, your next ad. Good people.
Oh, great people.
Oh, get them on board.
All right, Gode, we're having you on for this segment because it's obviously your favorite.
Welcome.
And you're obviously the funniest in the group. So we thought we'd get you to judge our choice of jokes this week.
Nice. Okay.
So as always, you can send these in on the chalk line. We got thechocolates.com.au. Hold the www dot. And
we're legit.
Yeah, we are legit. And we have a spoken one from AJ.
Yeah, it's AJ here. Got a little two-part joke for you. What do you call a deer with no eyes?
Yeah.
No idea. What do you call a spider with five eyes? A spider.
That's good. I haven't heard that one before. That's very good.
That was good.
First one, I tell that to my 8-year-old kids that I coach. They don't find it funny, so I don't think I'm going to. Second one, very good.
Okay, yeah.
Very good.
That's what made it really, the second one, I think.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah. We actually also have a written one. Sent in by Hayley. It goes like this. My girlfriend said I talked just like Justin Bieber. I said, what do you mean? You know the song, if you don't know it.
I got the song. No. That wasn't the issue with it.
I thought that was good.
No, you didn't.
Get out.
I thought it was really good.
Where the bosses get out.
No, you guys are the bosses.
And as always, the joke of the week is brought to you by our good friends at Better Beer. And we're obviously cracking a ginger in honor of Gode.
Thank you. I'm not. I've got an arvo.
Anyway, Gode, we have one more question for you before you go. How big do you actually think
finish the sentence.
Justin Bieber's thighs are? And if you need some help, you can just look.
I'd say that's pretty much in proportion. Like in proportion. Like I'd say I'm not so sure what's larger, his thighs or his eggplant, shall we say.
You know, it's exciting. You actually get to take that home.
Do I?
Oh, and that... frame it. I think Kathleen will love it.
But she sees that all the time at home anyway.
For those of you who aren't watching on YouTube, just then behind Gode was Justin Bieber with a giant eggplant.
Oh, yeah.
On his pants.
Yeah, on his pants.
Yeah.
Okay, and he loved it.
He loved it.
Absolutely adored it, actually.
Mitch also seems to love it.
Fantastic.
And for those of you who are confused why we are pranking the boys this episode, it's because they made us run a half marathon a couple of months ago.
Without knowing. Got to throw that in there. Yeah. Out on the day.
We went for breakfast. Didn't get breakfast.
No, yeah, didn't get breakfast.
Ran 21K. Cool, it was a great day.
Yeah,
hardly my fault, I'll be honest. I wasn't there.
Well, yeah, I kind of feel bad for you.
Anyway. Oh, no. Eloise, take it away.
Guys? All right. So, Mickus, you've recently gotten a Chuckies tattoo, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And you've also, you know, you've got a few tattoos. They put them up on the stories. You've got your Homer one, which I think's made it on the Chuckies platforms before, yeah? You got a few. You like tattoos.
Are you going to say that it's spelt wrong?
No, just...
Oh, wouldn't that be funny?
No, because it is. Anyway.
No, nothing's spelt wrong. You're all good. But, you know, you've got a lot of tattoos. You like getting tattoos, you'd say.
Can I get another one?
Yeah, yeah. So hang on. Just
Sorry.
It's a bit too much exciting coming to my room.
We're not driving here, Mickus.
So of all the tattoos that you've got, we're going to go through a rating. You know, of all the tattoos that you've got, what are your top two faves?
My top two faves. Honestly, the Homer one's my favorite.
Really?
Oh, God.
The rest of them are tied last.
And how many tattoos do you have, Mickus?
Oh, 20?
And maybe? You've got one that you like.
Yeah, the rest can actually go. Oh, well, they can't, so but they bad. I wish they could.
Yeah, that kind of ruins my next question. I was going to ask, what are your two least favorite? Is there one that you actually like?
Surely the one that's smudged.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
Smudged. Oh.
It was a dog that I had for about a year, like probably 7 years ago.
Okay. Yeah.
It was a black pug. He probably still is.
Did you go
and
away?
It literally just looks, yeah, I did. And I loved the dog for a moment. And then I gave him to someone else who could give him a better life. Okay. Anyway, not the point.
And now you've got a cat.
Not the point, yeah. And okay. God, is she a perfect little angel. But it just looks like a black smudge on my leg.
That's not even the one I was referring to. Don't you have a yin yang also from The Simpsons and Old Maids?
And that's also a smudge.
Yeah, it's like diseased.
Yeah, it's like Carl and Lenny from infection. The Simpsons. Yeah, Carl and Lenny from The Simpsons kind of blended into like a yin yang, but it kind of never healed properly and it looks like they're both
It's disgusting. Don't show that to people.
Okay.
Okay, are there any tattoos that you're planning on getting? I know on the way down, the big drive from the Hunter.
Yeah.
You know, we were talking about tattoos in the car and you were planning on one that was I thought was relatively questionable, but you and Leigh seem to love it.
Oh, yeah.
So any tattoos planning? Any coming up?
Oh, I think it'd be rude not to get a tattoo for Spencer Johnson, obviously.
Oh, that is so rude.
So I think that one, a little Elton Spawn.
Do you want to explain that a bit? What is that?
I think it's just going to be Spencer Johnson's face with Elton.
His face.
Elton. Oh. Well, like more of like an outline with Elton John glasses.
Oh.
Yeah.
So okay. I like it.
Okay. That's interesting. Anyway,
or a Christmas tree with Spencer Johnson's face on the top as like the little.
Have you gotten permission from Spencer Johnson to do this?
No, but I don't think he'd mind. Okay. He'd probably come get it with us.
Probably worth checking.
What?
No, I get it. Funny.
Well, Mickus, we actually have a phone call from someone and we're going to play that for you now.
Hi, Mickus. This is Brooklyn from Fable Tattoo. How are you going? Amazing. So we are just confirming your appointment for the 18th on Monday. Yeah, awesome. We'll see you then. Thanks. Bye.
You're kidding.
So, Mickus, I hope you're not busy tomorrow.
Yeah.
Because you do have an appointment to get a tattoo.
Where from? Sorry. Do I get? Where?
I actually don't know.
Yeah. Let's hope Dave's booked that one properly.
Some dodgy
place. I'm very cautious about where I get these tattoos. I'm not.
This lady sounds really good.
Yeah, great. Yeah,
really she's good. Lovely when we met her.
And sorry, am I picking the tattoo? Is it what I've just said? Or?
Oh, just
well, actually, so we've spent the previous week with your wife, Carly.
Legend, by the way.
And thank you for letting me know.
And Eloise, Carly and I had the best time designing some tattoos for you when we were together.
Oh, God.
So we're going to give you our top five options for you. So first is a glass of your favorite drink, a little Savvy B.
Yeah.
I'll get that.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. We feel okay with that one.
Yeah.
I love this next one personally.
I think this one's my favorite.
I'm dedicated to the one and only Disco Dave.
I'll get that.
Okay. any particular ideas?
I just
I didn't. Oh, he can do
these
the
are the concepts.
We've got the concepts ready and other stuff, but we'll just go through concepts
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
The next one is the office phrase that we've been going with the past month is yeah, baby.
Yeah, I'll get it.
Holy.
You're really twisting my arm here.
Yeah, wow, this is such a prank. next one is deck chair because you fold under pressure.
That's probably the number one.
Yeah, yeah. I thought we did think so.
Yeah,
we thought so, but number five is
and
the best.
The last one, this is, again, one of our personal favorites.
Yeah.
A lovely letter C for your beautiful wife, Carly.
Okay.
In a big, beautiful heart.
With an arrow through it.
Yeah, okay.
What's the one you seem most uncomfortable with?
I absolutely would like love to get something for Carly. I have an issue with getting a serious tattoo.
Okay, right.
Like, mm-hmm. I don't.
So when we put this up on the stories after we record this episode and we asked the Chockies to vote, everybody vote for number five.
Yeah, correct.
And that was Disco, right?
Nope, that was Carly.
No, it was not. So after hearing from Brooklyn from Fable Tattoos, who just called in, and because we love you, we wanted to do our due diligence. So we got the one and only Carly, Mickus's wife, to participate.
Yeah,
Mickus will literally get a tattoo at the drop of a hat anytime, any place. Not anywhere, though. So I think it's time to mix it up, and he has to get one on his butt cheek.
Nah.
What are you
I'll get a C on my butt.
What's wrong with the butt cheek? Why are you so hesitant about that?
I don't think that's that bad. Left or right cheek. That's the one bit you get to choose, left or right cheek.
Right.
Okay, cool.
Now left.
Oh, that's a classic gag, man.
Rock straight to that one.
Mitchell, aka Skin, as everyone here calls you. I don't call you that.
I know.
Yeah. Now, we know, we often talk about this, how much you love Mexican food, right?
Oh, yeah.
You love Mexican.
I do.
To the point, I think, you know, Gav, who's been on the podcast before, our financial advisor, has said to us, not said to us, but I think he thinks this when it goes through our accounts, your funding, Guzman and Gomez, good people, good people.
Great people.
Yeah. Yep. Well, yeah, yeah.
How many burritos?
Hoping one day I'll be able to buy
shares. How much Mexican food would you get away, do you reckon?
I'd visit Guzman 3 times a week, I reckon.
What the hell? I didn't know it was that much.
I mean, they're great
Three
people.
Times a they week. Are great. Why would buy groceries?
What do you want from it?
Money. okay, so firstly, what is your favorite Mexican food?
A burrito.
Wow. Big shock to everybody.
Yeah.
And we know, Mitch, that you, Skin, love to add some extras to your burrito, some toppings.
Okay.
So we thought we'd play a bit of a must or dust to go through some Mexican food toppings.
Okay,
and
cool.
Obviously we have a jingle.
We've got a jingle.
Whoa.
Is this must or dust? Is this must or dust? It won't take too long, so don't get it wrong. Is this must or dust?
Now keep it going.
Sorry.
What do we think of that, Elite?
Good.
I'd say scrap the other one, keep that.
I think that one was better.
Yeah. I actually tend to agree a little bit. Dave, why is the production on that better? Did you not do our original must or dust?
Okay. okay, so we're going to go through some items, must or dust.
Yep.
Firstly, guacamole.
Must.
Easy must.
Must.
Yeah, delicious.
Mick?
Oh, must. Absolutely. Yep.
Yeah.
Cheese, but not vegan cheese, just regular cheese.
Must.
Dust.
So much.
Must.
We don't care about you.
No,
so Mickus, much
wrong.
Cheese.
I mean, not Mickus. Mitch, you're wrong. Mickus, what do you reckon?
Dust.
What?
No cheese.
As if you're the biggest.
Bit of a cheese whore. I sorry, that's the time to cut that. Master.
Yeah. You can't say, I watched you pick cheese off your taco the other day.
All right,
that was
dust.
A lot of
you've convinced
thank you,
me.
Thank you.
Why are you like catching people out? Like, you're wrong. You can't say that.
Bitch, this is why people don't like vegans.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
All right, next one. Pinto beans. Beans.
Yeah. Mm, dust.
See, I love a bean. Okay. No, don't play that. I'm a good girl.
Okay, next one. Coriander.
Coriander.
Dust.
Yes, love it. Could eat it by the bunch.
Yeah.
Love it.
Must.
Did you say you could eat it by the bunch, Wheeze?
Yeah, literally.
Mitch, maybe you should buy Wheeze a bunch of coriander.
A bunch of anything would be nice.
A bouquet.
Okay. Final one.
All right.
This is a bit rogue. Cabbage.
Cabbage.
I don't know how it's cabbage. On there, but cabbage.
Is that? I've never put that on my Mexican food.
I wouldn't say must. Does cabbage go on Mexican?
Can you get it from GYG?
I don't know if they offer it.
You can get it from other places.
That's probably true.
I guess if you homemade your burritos, which I also do regularly, but.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I'm saying dust.
That's dust.
Now,
thanks for trying.
A real treat for you. Excuse me?
Nothing at all, dude.
A real shut up. I run this show. Now, a real treat for you. We actually have some burritos here for you to eat.
Oh,
isn't that a present? You know presents? Crikey. I like them. But actually includes some of Rochelle and I's favorite toppings. So,
they're
all vegan. Is this going to be like bloody extra hot
they're
sauce?
They're all vegan. We were nice. Take a pick. There's three there to choose from. You cannot feel them.
Can't.
You can pick one up. That's it. And that's your chosen one.
This one looks delicious.
I don't know what that means. I don't we're about to find out.
That's the other trick. Yep. You always got to slap your burrito. Got that from Ron.
Yeah, I thought so.
Great YouTube videos.
All right. Now's your moment. Open her up.
Oh, just eat it. Okay.
I think we can.
I can do that. Jeez, I'm in my element.
Can I eat the other one?
This is, you guys all got stuff.
Sure.
I've just got my favorite
Mick,
food.
But I'm getting five tattoos. That's hardly a stitch up.
I mean, Mick can have one if he wants one.
Yeah, do you want one?
Well,
yeah,
wait,
give one.
Can I wait to see what skin? I'm a bit nervous. I'm assuming they're all vegan.
Yeah, they're all vegan.
Yeah, that is important for you too, Mickus.
Yeah.
Just one big bite, Mitch.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Juicy.
Mickus, do you want to have a bite of yours?
Okay.
So we'll just explain what Mickus is biting into because his is a little bit more obvious.
What? Is that a burrito wrap burrito? What's happening?
No, it's just pure wrap.
It's just pure
that's
wrap.
That's what I mean.
Just a wrap. Just layers of wrap.
Do you
wrap.
Love that you wanted one now? Like just
I would
pure
suggest
bread.
Dust to that burrito. Not in my top couple. I suspect mine is spicier than I would normally order.
Oh, yeah.
Is that what's happening over here?
I really wish they picked the other one.
What's that one?
Do you want to try it?
Yeah, actually, yeah, we'll eat it.
I will not eat it. Mitch,
crikey. Is this Ron Guzman? Do they get this hot?
Oh, we had some add-ons.
Okay. Yeah, that is spicy.
Big bite, Mitch.
Big bite. Jesus, I wouldn't have done that, but that's all right.
Oh, my.
You do you. Brussels sprouts, baby. Your favorite.
Oh, no.
So Mitch has just eaten a burrito full of Brussels sprouts.
Mitch, and for anyone listening, Mitch hates Brussels sprouts. Oh. Of all the foods, I had to actually
try. Who doesn't hate Brussels sprouts?
Are they better in a burrito?
Yeah.
I actually had to try and think. I was like, what does Mitch not like? Because Mitch likes every food that's vegan. And that's what I came up with.
Are these also raw?
Yeah,
I tried. Could you cook them for me?
No, it makes it better. I tried to cook them, but yeah, it didn't really work.
Okay, thank you.
The chewing.
All right, and finally, you're in for a tweet.
Oh.
Yeah, we did it.
She's quick on the buttons.
She's quick. Oh, we might have a replacement in line. Leigh.
See you, Leigh.
I've been worried about your jaw.
It was quicker than. Yeah. I think they've heard it.
Just checking. It's all right.
Just making sure the button works.
Yeah, exactly. All right. So this tweet has come, we found, from Hannah Emily. Mm-hmm. How dare the girl I spend one day with in Berlin 2 years ago unfollow me on Instagram?
I don't know if that's fair.
No, I hate
it. I need
that.
The support.
What do you mean?
Once a follower, always a follower, I think.
Yeah, and if anyone wants to go over.
I'm surprised by the reaction. Okay.
That is not true from you.
Yeah, I know. I unfollow people. But they should always follow.
No, no, no. Take your followers,
but don't unfollow anyone, because if anyone does want to find a good Instagram account, you can go click on Eloise and Ice.
We have one at Eloise.Allen.
At Rochelle.
Real Lul. Creative.
I mean, bang, while we're there, your mate, Mick.
This is Ladies Night, Mick.
Yeah.
Radio. That's another We Got the Chocolates podcast complete. We welcome you to be a part of the Chockies crew and get in touch with us on the socials. You can do that at We Got the Chocolates everywhere.
And you can also help us by visiting our website, which is www. But it's just wegotthechocolates.com. We do have merch there.
Nah, hold it. You don't need it.
I'm doing a great job. We have merch there. You will find the chalk line where you can send anything you like, jokes, questions, stories, or lyrics substitute skins. There is even a game on the website that will give you a merch discount if you can complete it. So check that out. Leave a rating. Or
and
a review.
Yep.
On our favourite Instagram.
And make this one 5 stars.
On our favourite Instagram. What is that?
If you could rate this one 5 stars and just ignore the end bits that Wiz has said, that's fine.
If you could subscribe just to this one episode.
The Instagram, Eloise.Allen, sounds pretty good. Anyway, and a comment on YouTube. Leave a comment on YouTube. We do love reading through those as well.
Especially this one.
Yeah, this one. Lots of comments, please.
And remember to get out there and enjoy having a chinwag with your mates this week. If you're doing that, you were absolutely getting the chocolates. We'll speak to you this time next week and every other week for the rest of our lives.
We're taking over. One little takeaway. We like to leave a takeaway with everyone. A bit different to all the boys.
Oh,
do.
Just some homework?
Yeah, just some homework.
So, Leigh, if you could go home and do the dishes.
Mm. Mitch, love a massage. Do your jobs.
Pick boys up a vacuum.
Girls, do your jobs. Yeah, we love jobs.
It's a great takeaway for everyone else. It's very pointed at two people.
Correct. It's, you know, subtle, but not subtle at all.
All right, we'll speak to you next week. Good luck in the future. And that stumps.
Love you.